One other thing about Gujarat is that that's where the Gir Forest is. The Gir Forest is the only place in the world where you can find Asiatic lions. Now, Asiatic lions are not exactly like African lions. In fact, there's a separate subspecies, although they're the same species. And one way you know that they're not quite the same is because if you cross an Asiatic lion with an African lion, the cubs are not likely to turn out right. Nevertheless, it's the Asiatic lion which is in most of our mythology. It's the Asiatic lion that was on the Barbary Coast. That's the lion that the Romans used in their amphitheaters for the most part. It was also out in the Middle East, Asia, Europe. The Greek myths all have to do with the Asiatic lion rather than the African lion. Now, that's interesting because, you see, the African lion is believed to be the original lion, the basal lion. And lions are thought to have gotten out of Africa maybe 20,000 years ago. Now, what that means is that people left Africa before the lions did. The lions have a very hard time getting through tropical areas, and they had a hard time getting through the Sahara Desert and the Rift Valley. And that tends to keep the African lions trapped in Africa. But those that got out were very populous at one time. However, about 100 years ago, there were only about 10 left, and they were all in the Gir Forest. It's only because of the local nobility that set aside this area for the lions when they realized that this was the only place you could find Asiatic lions, that the lions had a chance of avoiding extinction. And they're still quite close to it.
Let's start with a train ride that goes through the Gir Forest. You don't see a whole lot of animals from the train, but they're there. In fact, they happen to be right there at the train station. And as soon as the train's gone, the langur monkeys come out and become visible. The langurs are a large monkey, old world monkey, and they have a black face, and they're sometimes called black-faced monkeys. But they always remind me of old men because of their white fur. Their beards and their hair appear to be white, and they have the very bushy eyebrows. They look kind of like they should be college professors. But notice here, the langurs are not alone. They are, in fact, part of a, well, you could call it a mixed herd. The cheetah, the small spotted deer, is also often found with the langurs. Now, there is a good reason for that. One is the langurs can go up into the trees and pick fruit, and they're frankly messy eaters. And so the deer like to be eating under the trees where the monkeys are working to pick up the leftovers. The other reason is because they make a good anti-predator team. The cheetah can smell the predator quite well. And the result of that is that it is frequently the first to give an alarm call. But the langur can give an alarm call usually only if it sees the predator, and therefore it's more reliable. The train is interesting, but by far the better way to see the animals in the Gir Forest is by the traditional safari vehicle. And so we're up at dawn, actually a little before dawn, and going into the park. One of the things that you notice pretty quickly is that there are domesticated animals like these water buffalo in the park. And in fact, there are indigenous people that are living inside the park. This is an indigenous village, and it's built basically around a large corral. When the animals, the domesticated animals, are out and about during the day, they're brought in for the night to protect them from the predators. Here we have a monitor lizard. Monitor lizards have very thick necks. Those neck muscles are how it breathes. They act kind of like a bellows into the lungs. Also, when I was a kid, there were only two venomous lizards. The Gila monster and the Mexican beaded lizard. Now we know that all the monitor lizards as well are venomous. Next is an animal I haven't seen in 25 years, and then I only saw it briefly and not well. It's a nilgay, known in English as a blue bull. The male is blue in the same sense that a horse tends to be blue, and it is India's largest antelope. In fact, I think it's taller than the African eland, although it's not as heavy as an African eland. These nilgay, of course, are female and therefore not really blue. It may look here like someone has been careless with matches or something, but this isn't really a forest fire, although it is in a forest and it is a fire. This is a controlled burn, what they use to clean up the forest and keep a serious fire from getting started. Now, this is what we've come for, the Asiatic male lions. And they're strolling down the road as though they owned it, and in fact they do. You can tell that they're Asiatic lions because of that fold of skin underneath their bellies. And they're followed by paparazzi. This next is a courting couple, and you can tell that she's pretty enthusiastic. He's not quite so enthusiastic about courting right now. And this next thing that you'll see is called a flamen response. That is, he's trying to check to see whether or not she's ready. And apparently he doesn't believe she's ready to conceive as much as she does. This is terribly hard work for the male, apparently. They have to couple about 100 times on average for each cub that is produced. Normally, they should be coupling every 5 or 10 minutes, but it's just not happening. Now, here's a mom that's got 3 cubs that she's coming home to, and they're just about to greet her. She picks up the kids and they're headed off to the watering hole. That little squeak that you hear every once in a while is a chital predator warning. Since cubs are one of the cutest little fur balls around, I thought that I'd basically stop talking, or slow down talking anyway, and let you watch them for a while.
Perhaps, if you could have a little bit of a mistake. think pehli baar leke nikle na baar sab nazara tha dekho allah ye kitne mein lega na bole do bole
Well, once you're getting tired of playing Kill Your Siblings, it's time to play Kill Mom. And it looks now like the milk bar is about ready to open. Now that Mom's had enough to drink anyway. It's evening, and a sambar deer, which is larger than the chital deer, is walking nervously around a watering hole. There's something wrong. Then there's a little cat face at the watering hole. This is a young leopard. The leopard hasn't come down to stalk the sambar deer. It is instead also here for a drink. Nevertheless, the sambar deer decides discretion is the better part and leaves the neighborhood. There are nearly as many leopards here as there are lions, but you never see them. The leopard is the prince of darkness, and unlike the lion, he hates to be seen. Between the light fading and the fact that we have to stand far off in order to be able to view the leopard at all, these pictures are a little grainier than I would like. Now, with light fading, we need to change our attention from the Gir Forest to the foothills of the Himalaya Mountains, which is our main objective.